أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين بارئ الخلائق أجمعين والحمد لله الذي بعد فلا يرى وقرب فشهد النجوى تبارك وتعالى والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب قلوبنا وطبيب نفوسنا وشفيع ذنوبنا أبو القاسم محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا أما بعد سلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته Yesterday we started by asking ourselves a question and laying emphasis on the fact that human being created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs to realize the purpose of his own existence. Needs to contemplate on why he has been created. Needs to know that there is a distinction between him and all other creations. He needs to understand that he stands high above all other creation. He needs to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made him ashraful makhluq. But he also needs to understand why he is ashraful makhluq. He needs to know why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made him the best of the creation. Because the higher the responsibility, the better you are before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greater the responsibility of an individual as to what is expected of this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the best of the creation. What is expected of me before my Lord? Is it salat and sawm and hajj and zakat and khums and jihad and amr bil ma'ruf and nahi anil munkar? Is it these forms of worship that are expected of me that makes me distinct from all other creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is it these du'as that we recite, the salat that we pray, the supplications that we make, that makes us the best of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is it the desire for paradise or seeking release from the fire of hell that I have or that I fear all the time is what the purpose and the goal of my life is? One of the mystic by the name of Rabia al-Dawiyya of Basra was once seen holding a container of water in her hands and some fire in the other hand. And she was seen running amongst the mystics. So the mystics asked her a question. They said, "Where are you rushing with fire in your hand and a pot of jug or jug with water in your pot of water in your hands? Where are you going? Where are you rushing towards?" And she responded by saying that with this water I am going to extinguish the fire of hell. And with this fire I am going to burn the paradise. So the mystics said, "Why do you want to burn the paradise? And why do you want to extinguish the fire of hell?" She immediately responds by saying, "Because I want people to see God without paradise and without hell. I want them to have a clear view of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the view of Allah that they have is the view of paradise. It is paradise in front of them. This is what they want. This is how they see themselves. This is what I want. Or I am seeking release from the fire of hell, my Lord. Grant me release from the fire of hell." That is all. Is that why? Or is it because my final destination needs to be Jannah? And I must go to this Jannah, the Jannah that I have in my mind, the Jannah in which there is hoor, the Jannah in which there is milk, the Jannah in which there is honey, the Jannah in which there is trees, the Jannah in which there is everything that I imagine in my mind, a paradise, you know. When the Holy Prophet of Islam, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, brought the message before the people. Because the time today is short, I will continue with how the people responded to the Holy Prophet of Islam, for us to understand the mentality of the people who he was speaking to, and probably see ourselves in that particular mentality. When he brought that message of La ilaha illallah tuflihu, say there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you shall succeed in everything in your life. Immediately the people had skepticism about the message that the Holy Prophet of Islam brought. They looked at him and they asked him several questions. One of the questions that bothered them was that the Holy Prophet was a human being, that he was promising us something as a human being. And one of the demands that they made from the Holy Prophet of Islam at that time was that he should show them أَوْ تَكُونَ لَكَ جَنَّةٌ مِّن نَخِيلٍ وَعِنَبٍ فَتُفَجِّرَ الْأَنْهَارَ خِلَالَهَا تَفْجِيرًا. Surah Banu Israel, verse number 92. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that immediately they said to the Prophet, you know, you need to show us something, something like a paradise. So there was a paradise in their minds that they were looking for. جَنَّةٌ أَوْ تَكُونَ لَكَ جَنَّةٌ مِّن نَخِيلٍ. This place that you have should have trees, palm trees, date trees, jannatun min nakhil, wa inab, and there should be grape trees that you have, vines there. Wa tufajjir al anhara khilalaha tafjira, and there should be rivers flowing underneath it. In their mind, it was this paradise. In my mind, what paradise is it? What paradise am I looking for when I want to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when I'm saying, Allahumma adkhilni al-jannah, my Lord, grant me paradise. What is the picture of this paradise that I have in my mind? So, when I look at myself and I ask myself, is it for that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me? Is it seeking release from the fire of hell that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me? What is it that makes me distinct? Who would not want a paradise? And even if I did get this paradise that I have made in my mind, the Jannah that I have made in my mind, because there are many verses of Quran that describe this paradise. But the description of this paradise and what I have made in my mind, I need to understand that is it for this that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created me. This month of Ramadan, it is time for you and I to contemplate, to think, our Lord, I am fasting, lillahi sumt, only for you am I fasting. But what am I achieving out of this fast? What is it that is making me distinct from all other creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? In Surah Al-Ahzab, there is a very interesting verse known as the ayah of amana, the ayah of trust. And in this particular verse, when you go back home, inshaAllah ta'ala, look at this verse in Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is called as the verse of amana. He says, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ. We presented to the heavens a trust, and we presented to the earth a trust, and we presented to the mountains a trust. So there was a trust, Allah says. This is pre-creation of human being, pre-physical creation of human being, pre-creation of the physical creation of all that. Allah says, we had a trust in our hands. We presented this trust to the heavens. We presented this trust to the earth. And we presented this trust to the mountains. The heavens and the earth and the mountains are symbolisms of might, of greatness. So Allah says, we presented, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ. We presented it to them. وَأَبَيْنَا أَن يَحْمِلْنَهَا. The mountain refused to carry this amana. the earth refused to carry this amana, as well as the heavens. They all said, "Wa ashfaqna minha." They refused to carry this amana. They screamed out that we cannot carry this amana, our Lord. Guess what happened next? فَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ. Human being went forward. And he said, "Our Lord, I will carry this amana." What was rejected by the heavens with all its might, what was rejected by the earth with all its might, what was rejected by the mountains with all the might of the mountain, man went and said, فَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ. Insan carried it and said, "My Lord, I will take it." You know what God says? إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Indeed, this man is most ignorant, and he is one who is oppressing himself. My Lord, what was rejected by everybody was taken by me. Still I am jahil. Still I am zalim. If we ponder over this verse, we will begin to realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed the befitting responsibility upon me for me to become that insan that He wants me to become. I was the one who was, I talk about insan. Insan was the one who carried this amana. Let us study what this amana is. Let us look at this amana and see, my Lord, what is this amana that makes me, or that I carried, that everybody else rejected, that makes me the perfect human being, the perfect human being in the sense of better than all other creations. It is at that point that I will begin to realize my responsibility, what I am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran says, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا. Did you really think that we created you in vain? وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And that you shall not return back to us. Really? Did you really think that was the purpose of our creation? Did you think we created you just in play? And that there is no responsibility for you? Or do you realize that you have a huge responsibility on your shoulder? The least is to become insan, to become a human being. A poet in Urdu says, Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, Amir al-Mu'mineen has a beautiful poem. You may have heard it many times, but let me repeat it here. It is a beautiful poem that gives us a glimpse or an insight of what a human being is. He says in this beautiful poem, he says, دَوَاءُكَ فِيكَ وَمَا تَبْصُرُ. The cure lies within you, but you do not see it. وَدَاءُكَ مِنْكَ وَمَا تَشْعُرُ. And the illness is also from within you, but you do not realize it. And then he says, وَأَنْتَ الْكِتَابُ الْمُبِينَ الَّذِي بِأَحْرُفِهِ يَظْهَرُ الْمُضْمَرُ. And you are an open book. You are a book. Every letter of it is made manifest. Every hidden of it is made manifest. And then Amir al-Mu'mineen says, he settles the score by this particular verse. He compels human being to start pondering and thinking when he says, أَتَزْعَمُ أَنَّكَ جِرْمٌ صَغِيرٌ. Do you consider yourself to be an insignificant mass? وَفِيكَ إِنْ طَوَى الْعَالَمُ الْأَكْبَرُ. When within you resides a huge universe. Do you think you are nothing? You are insignificant? Do you think you have absolutely nothing in you? وَفِيكَ انْطَوَى الْعَالَمُ الْأَكْبَرُ. When within you there is a huge universe. Look at yourself and ask yourself a question. Are you that human being to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regarding whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the angels, regarding this man, إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. I know the worth of this man that you do not know. while the angels had one view of this man, that he is going to create corruption, he is going to create facade on earth, this man is going to create all kinds of mischief on earth. Allah says, "Na inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun." I know about this man. If he decides to understand him, if he learns about himself, if he taps his own potential, if he explores his own self, this man can rise above the ranks of the angels. And if this man decides to leave himself, and if he decides to neglect himself, and if he decides not to see himself at all, then he has the potential of falling lower than the ranks of the animals. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. They are like cattle. لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا. They are men, they have hearts, but they do not think with them. وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. They have ears, but they do not hear with them. They have eyes, but they do not see with those eyes. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ. They are like cattle. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. No, they are worse than cattle. So my potential, what is this verse of Amana? And how does this verse of Amana, and how do I understand this verse of Amana? My Lord, why have you created me? And what is expected of me as a human being? Give me that knowledge, that understanding for me to realize. Amirul Mu'mineen says, within you lies a huge universe. An Urdu poet says, Yun agar dekhiye, kya kuch nahi ye mushte ghubar. If you look at him, what is it that this man is not, that this body, that this physical man is not? Yun agar dekhiye, kya kuch nahi ye mushte ghubar. Aur agar sochiye, to khak bhi insaan mein nahi. And if you think, then he is not even worth soil, khak. It is up to him. He either raises himself higher than the status of the angels, or he drops himself lower than the animals. That is what the Holy Prophet of Islam wanted when he brought Islam. These were the messages that he gave to the people. And there were those who were skeptics, and there were those who understood the Prophet. And both of them came before the Holy Prophet of Islam. And we will, inshaAllah ta'ala, talk about this more tomorrow, as to what happened when the Holy Prophet did, and how he came and removed and emancipated people from all that they were in, and allowed them this freedom, and allowed them to grow, and allowed them to think, and allowed them to realize their own potential, until he created people like Abu Dharr and Salman al-Farisi. From nowhere, from the community that considered killing as normal, from a community that considered incest as common and normal, from the community that considered burying little girls alive as normal and ordinary, as if it was never a problem, from that community, from those people whose mindset was such that they had absolutely no realization of what the true truth was, from those communities the Holy Prophet of Islam removed them. He showed them the light and created Abu Dharr and Salman al-Farisi, Miqdad and Ammar al-Yasir. It is that potential of human being that man needs to realize. He needs to ask this question to himself: why am I created? Why such a sophistication in me? Why does he congratulate himself after creating me? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so proud after creating man? فَتَّبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. Glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best of the creators, only after creating man. And here it is, this man. Sometimes you begin to wonder. And Amir al-Mu'mineen says, وَفِيكَ انْطَوَى الْعَالَمُ الْأَكْبَرُ. Within you lies a great big universe. And here it is, this man who begins to look at himself and thinks that he is everything. He looks at himself and he gets lost in his ego. And he begins to think, I am I. And he begins to think, had it not been for me, nothing would have happened. And he begins to look at himself as a huge ego within him, which prevents him from seeing his true potential. He starts looking at himself and thinks, Allahu Akbar, it was not me, nothing would have happened. Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. In one of his statements, if we can imagine when Imam alayhi salatu wasalam used to say words amongst the people, and if we can only imagine and go back in the world of imagination and try to look at the facial expression of Imam when he said this, you would start to think, surely Imam was smiling and laughing when he was saying this. When he says, Ajibtu, I am really wondering, I am surprised at the person who has takabbur, who looks at himself and thinks he is something. How can he even begin to think when awwaluhu nutfa wa akhiruhu jifa? When his beginning is sperm, najis, when his end is a stinking corpse. In between he thinks he is something. How can he even think about himself as this? So this man loses himself in seeing himself as this without realizing that there is a huge universe that exists in him which is crying out, I am here not for the purposes that I see, but for the purposes of becoming this insan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to become. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you and I the tawfiq to be able to understand Islam better. Wassalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.